Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? I hope that you all are doing well, staying in your home and take caring of yourself. As we all know that we are going through a pandemic due to COVID-19, we should stay in our home. Okay, do one thing, just wash your hands frequently in a day at least for 20 seconds. And don't let your elders go outside the home, and if there is any emergency, tell them to take precaution and then go. Okay, we have to study, right? That's why I decided to make some videos about your chapters. Now I am going to explain about chapter 6, which is modern trend from class 5. I hope you are sitting with your books and exercise book. Open page number 119, chapter 6, modern trends. Okay. In this chapter, we will explain about different things like medicine, science, art, socialism, Daoism, and all. Okay. Today, I'm going to explain about half of the chapter. First half, medicine. As we all know that medicine seems to stand still for many centuries, but after the middle of the 19th century, there were remarkable advances. Okay, medicine is important every time, but after 19th century, it took a great place. Okay, some of these were because of medical discoveries, some discoveries of social or political changes. First of all, medicine. Anesthetics. In 1840s, the first anesthetics were used in the USA and Scotland to put people to sleep for operation. Which means that when anesthetic was invented in 1840s, it was using to make people sleep where the doctor did the operation. Okay, but unfortunately the people died because no one knew about the germs. But people were dying because of what? Because they don't know about the germs. They were getting infected by the infected by the germs, and the death rate was rising. Okay, after that, antiseptics. In the 1860s, the Frenchman Pasteur discovered germs, and the Englishman Lister found a way of killing some of them with antiseptics. This made a great change in the number of the death. Okay, so antiseptic invented in 1860s. X-rays. In the 1890s, the German Röntgen discovered X-rays. This helped doctors to find out what disease people had. What do you know about X-ray? X-ray is a technology or a machine by which you can see what is going in your inside, body's inside, right? So it helped doctors to find out the disease people had in their bodies. Okay. Antibiotics. They then come to the another point, antibiotics. Okay, the Englishman whose name was Fleming, he discovered penicillin in 1930s. Mark this line. You can mark this line. When, if I ask you a question in the semester, when penicillin discovered? Okay, penicillin. So your answer must be penicillin discovered in 1930s. And who invented it or who discovered it? The Englishman Fleming discovered it. Understand? Okay. And do you know one thing, that penicillin or any kind of antibiotic work in human body which other drugs cannot do? Okay, then come to another point, which is water and sanitization. Although the second half of the 19th century, piped water and sewage system were put in houses. This reduced many infectious diseases such as typhoid and cholera. Today we use piped water and we have toilets in our home, but before there were no piped water or no toilet or only one or two toilets for more than 100 families or 100 peoples. Okay, so that was miserable. As far I remember, in our previous classes I have explained about this situation. Okay, better housing. Today we have better houses, isn't it? Today we have 5 and 5-star buildings, and we have hi-fi houses, isn't it? But before, their houses were not so good. Okay, like better housing. Although in the 19th and 20th century, housing became much better and there was less overcrowding. They reduced transmission and helped to stop other diseases spreading. Okay, better diet. Food improved all through in the 19th and 20th century because of the better transport, better farming and spread of ideas about diet. People were much healthier because they had more and better food. For the revolution or for the use of transport, now people are getting healthier and fresher food. Okay, health services. Most countries in the second half of the 20th century have free or very cheap medical services for the people. Clinics are set up where people can go prevent diseases instead of treating them when they have broken out. Like in our country, in Bangladesh, there are lots of hospitals by the government or the clinics by the government where people can go and take health services from there. Understand? Okay, I hope you're sitting with your book. In page number 119, you can see a graph where the world population shows. Okay, the graph shows roughly the number of people in the world over the last 500 years. In the past, diseases and famine kept the population down, but today medicine makes sure that fewer people are dying. So these are the importance or these are the benefits of medicine. Okay, now less people are dying, that's why the population rate is growing day by day. Understand? Okay, then come to another point, which is aging people. Okay, as the people are not dying, they are surviving. That means that aging people are increasing day by day. Okay, the chart below shows the number of people in different age group in Britain from 19th century, and there are will be 19 and 91. Notice that as well as more people are together, the proportion in the age groups has changed. Up to the age 30, the number are little different, but after that there are many more older people, especially after the age of retirement. Okay, now turn the page. Okay, another portion of this chapter, science. The 20th century in the country of science. The 20th century is the century of science. These are some of the most important developments that have taken place. One of them is electricity, another is automation, then electronics, computers, nuclear power, space researches and all. Okay, first of all, electricity. Okay, although electricity is one form of another had been known for 100 years, it was not until the 20th century that it was used in a particular large scale way. Electricity has revolutionized industry and transport, making them cleaner, quieter, faster and more efficient when compared with the steam power. But it is in over everyday's life electricity had most effect. Tell me one thing, can you think a single day without electricity? No one can even think a single hour without electricity, because we need electricity all the times, right? As I am talking with you through the mobile phone or through the video chat, I need electricity to send it, isn't it? Okay, now come to another point, automation. In the industrial revolution of the 19th century, the steam engine took over from hand power. Electric power took over from the steam engine in the 20th century and machine became more complicated. But the idea with the same, a worker operate the machine. In the second half of the 20th century, engineers invented automation. That is, machine which would control other machines. Instead of having one worker at each machine, there would be one man at the control equipment and these would operate perhaps a dozen other machines automatically. Understand what I said? That there will be one machine which only a worker need to control and other machines are controlled by that specific machine, which is called the automation. Understand? Okay, electronics. simple radio equipment was known at the beginning of the 20th century, but until World War II, it was very fragile and clumsy because it used large and delicate glass valves. Soon after World War II, the transistor was invented. This was cheap and though are very small and did all the radio valves could do, but much better. In the 1960s, the silicon chip was invented. You can mark the line. In the 1960s, the silicon chip was invented. Understand? Now come to another point, which is computer. Computers are electronic machines which can do calculation millions of times faster than any human being. They can remember more facts than a million humans' brain. Okay. Let me tell you one thing, that human can do everything, okay, but computer can do it faster. If you give a sum to a computer, some mathematics to a computer, it will take 10 to 5 seconds. But if you give me a sum, I will take 1 minute or more than that or less than that. Why I'm telling you that? To know the difference between human being and the computer. Okay, so computer can do any of some very faster. Okay, now nuclear power. Every year the world uses more and more energy. We have known for a long time that sooner or later the supplies of coal or oil will run out. Perhaps sooner than the most people think. An alternative source of power has to be found quickly. For almost a century, men have dreamed of getting unlimited energy from the atom. In World War II, the atomic bomb was created. We all know, right? In World War II, the atomic bomb was created, okay, to destroy their enemy. But after that, this provide unbelievable heat and explosive power for a second or two. After the war, scientists found a way of controlling the nuclear reaction and using it to heat water to drive electricity generations. Can you imagine? When a nuclear atom bomb can destroy the enemy within 1 or 2 seconds, the scientists make it equipment to heat the water for produce electricity after World War II. Okay, and I know that you are very intelligent and you all know about space researches. So here is it. Serious space researches also begin in World War II when the Germans sent huge rockets to bomb Britain. After the war, the USSR and USA made more and more powerful rockets for military purpose. Okay, in 1957, the Russians, and in 1958, the Americans launched unnamed satellites, which went around the Earth 120 miles up. And in 1961, the USSR put the first man into space. Okay, after the two countries raced against each other using large spacecraft with up to 4 crew, they sent unnamed spacecraft to the moon and towards the sun and other planes to take photographs. In 1969, the Americans landed men on the moon. As we all know that Neil Armstrong, okay, he went to moon in 1969. Okay, that's for all today. Thank you.